Sigmund Freud's alarm would ring at 7 a.m. He'd take 1 hour to eat breakfast, then trim his beard before seeing his first patient at 8 a.m. After lunch, he'd take a walk, then from 3 p.m. to 9 p.m., he'd see more patients. Then he'd retire to play cards and end each day journaling until 1 a.m. The French writer Victor Hugo, by contrast, took a more leisurely approach. Awakened by gunshot, he'd slurp 2 raw eggs and spend 7 hours drinking coffee, bathing, and penning love letters to his mistress. He exercised at the beach for 2 hours, then visited his barber. Following an afternoon carriage ride, Hugo would finally start writing at 6 p.m. 2 hours later, he'd finish. The working schedules of the greatest minds in history can seem indulgent compared to the modern work week. High workloads increase your risk of being diagnosed with an illness by 35%. Longer hours increase mortality by nearly 20%. Studies have also shown that people become worse at their job the more that they do it per week. Within 20 years, computers may replace more than half of people in current US jobs. This doesn't have to be bad news, though. In theory, this is a golden opportunity to free human workers up for the more creative and pleasurable work that's left. Given total freedom, how would you structure your work week? Let us know in the comments or join the conversation on Facebook.